Hello, very good afternoon. I feel privileged and it gives me a great pleasure to extend a hearty welcome to all the attendees, faculty members, proud parents, and our very lovely students. I'm R.K. Thakur. I'm a dean at the School of Basic and Applied Sciences at G.D. Goenka University. As you note, today we are in the seventh session. We have started this career science education, career prospects, career counseling session. And here we are in the seventh session. This session is dedicated for chemical sciences, chemistry. As you know, that education has been used as a tool for social changes since time immortal. Therefore, education is at our heart of our effort, both to adapt, to change, and to transform the world within which we live. So, dear colleagues, as you know, this session, all these sessions are designed to interact young and talented students to remain in a science domain, science mathematics domain, or engineering domain that could strengthen the science and technological part of this country. So, as we always believe that given our socio-economic dynamics of our nation, university usually plays a role to enhance the employability of young United Indians and help the economy acquire a competitive edge. To this end, at G.D. Goenka University, we have various 12 schools who are constantly been updating the program and pedagogies to provide a quality education to all our students, national or international, crossing national or international boundaries. So as I said, this is the seventh session dedicated to the chemical sciences. So as I'm sure you might be aware that in ancient history, if we go back to the 100,000 before, orchid processing workshop was found in a Bloomberg cave in a South African region. That indicated that the early humans had an elementary knowledge of chemistry. So, you know, the chemistry is so much important. There, the paintings drawn by early humans consisting of early humans mixing animal blood with the other liquid found on a cave walls also indicate a small knowledge of chemistry. So the chemistry took its present scientific form in the 18th century when carefully quantitative experiments by Lavoisier, Proust and Dalton resulted in a law of definite proportions. The law of conservation of mass and law of multiple proportion, which laid the groundwork for Dalton's atomic theory of matter. I'm sure you all might be aware about all these things. If you go a little bit more in the history of chemistry, that represented a time span for ancient history. About 1000 BC, the civilization used technologies that would eventually form the basis of various branches of chemistry. Examples include the discovery of fire, extracting metals from ores, making pottery and glazes, fermenting beer and wine, extracting chemicals from plants for medicine and perfume, rendering fat into soap, making glasses, and making alloys like a bronze. The philosophical attempt to rationalize why different substances have a different properties like a color, density, a smell that exist in a different states such as gaseous, liquid, and solid, and react in a different manner when exposed to environments, for example, to water or a fire or a temperature changes, led ancient philosophers to postulate the first theory of nature and chemistry. The history of such philosophical theories that relate to chemistry can probably be traced back to every single ancient civilization. So one can understand how it is important. Roughly around 420 BC, Empedocles stated that all matter is made up of four elemental substances such as earth, fire, air, and water. The early theory of atomism can be traced back to ancient Greek and ancient India as well. So, you know, the chemistry has a lot of scope. So understanding of the nature of matter has evolved. So too has the self-understanding of the science of chemistry by its practitioners. This continuous historical process of evaluation includes the categories, terms, aims, scope of chemistry. Additionally, the development of the social institution and network which support actually the chemical inquiry are highly significant factors that enable the production, dissemination, and application of chemical knowledge. Dear colleagues, in this session, as I said, this session is devoted to the career opportunities in chemical sciences, and our speaker is Dr. Sonika Sethi. Dr. Sethi is an assistant professor at the School of Basic and Applied Sciences. She is a chemist with a background in organic chemistry. She is an expert with the comprehensive knowledge of both organic and inorganic synthesis techniques, characterization of compounds by elemental analysis like a TLC, HPLC, GMAMS, LCMS, NMR, UVVIS, and IR spectroscopy, etc. So many sophisticated cutting-edge technologies. Dr. Sethi holds a PhD from IIT Roorkee and MSc Organic Chemistry from Delhi University. She ranked first across the Delhi University throughout her undergraduate studies and received the award by then late CM of Delhi, late Sheela Dikshit ji. Dr. Sonika was awarded the prestigious Science Meritorious Award for 5 straight years at Delhi University. She is also JRF and NET GATE qualified. She holds a total of research and teaching experiences of almost more than 10 years. Prior to her career in academics, she worked with the reputed chemical industry as well. So Dow Chemicals Private Limited at Pune. So she has a wide experience, not only in a teaching, but also in a industrial sector. She has published more than 20 research or review articles in SCI index journals and has authored some books like Chromatographic Inotosiferation of Pharmaceutical Compounds, which has been published by the German publishers. She has also published some chapters in encyclopedia such as Reference Module on Chemistry, Molecular Science and Chemical Engineering through the Elsevier. She has represented several papers in national and international conference, symposia, and workshop. So as you know, she has a wide experience in this field. And therefore, I do believe that in this session, she will focus in depth about the chemistry. Chemistry is a part of our everyday life, which helps to develop subject-specific skills valued by all employers and thus opens door to a wide range of careers, most of which aim to solve global government field. The School of Basic and Applied Sciences at GD Goenka University provides opportunities to get the BSc, MSc, and PhD degrees in chemistry besides some PG diplomas. Students and staff are carrying out research in an atmosphere of support and encouragement in various important fields of chemistry. In this session, a brief introduction will be given about the importance of chemistry, career opportunity, future prospect, and of course, the course offered at the School of Basic and Applied Sciences at GD Goenka University, various facilities available, brief introduction of our faculties, and so on. So, ladies and gentlemen, with this word, I would like to invite Dr. Sonika Sethi to conduct this session. And however, prior to that session, I may kindly urge all of you to listen carefully throughout the session. It is really very much important. As you know, I'm sure most of you might have gone through all our 6 sessions. So faculty put a lot of effort to prepare all this slides to navigate you, to give you feeling about the subject so that you have a possibility to think very carefully before choosing a career. So whether you are fit in a science, if yes, then in which domain of science, which stream of science, whether it is a chemistry, physics, biochemistry, forensic, mathematics, and so on. So I may request you to listen carefully. If you have any question, any doubt, you have a possibility to drop in a chat box your question. We have dedicated faculty members and they will note it down, all your queries. And at the end of the session, we will open the discussion and there you have a possibility to ask your question. Either our faculty member will ask question on your behalf or we will request you to unmute your mic and you can ask your question. We will open the session for 10 or 15 minutes. Thank you so much. Till then, I may kindly request you to mute your mic and also mute your camera off so that resource person can go smoothly with the presentation. Thank you once again to all ladies and gentlemen, and I welcome you to stay throughout this session. And I also welcome Dr. Sethi for the talk, and please continue.
Thank you so much, sir, for the introduction.
Welcome.
A very warm good evening to all the participants. Is my voice clear?
Yeah, it is clear.
Yeah. Okay. A very warm welcome to all of you, a very good evening to the seventh session on career opportunities in chemical sciences. In this session, you will get answers to what is chemistry, why is it important, what you can do with the chemistry degree, when and what to study, the job profiles that you get, recruiting sectors, chemistry at our university, and what is our university for students. So, most of the introduction has already been given by Professor Thakur. Let's begin with chemistry, what chemistry is. Chemistry actually began as a physical science, but that quite did not fit the definition of physics. So it's actually study of matter, but is obsessed with affecting changes to matter at molecular level, rather than the forces and laws that govern the changes. So in short, it actually involves the study of matter, its properties and behavior, and plastics, dyes, explosives, pharmaceuticals, carbon nanocomposites, coatings, paints, whatnot. Everything has like chemical roots in it. So chemistry is everywhere, and so is matter, and thus chemistry matters. Chemistry matters to each one of us. Then chemistry has been actually broadly classified in five main branches. The first one being organic chemistry. It is the study of matter that contains carbon. The organic chemist studies structure, function, synthesis, and identity of carbon compounds. And these studies are generally carried out in petroleum industries, pharmaceuticals, or polymer industries. Then second branch of chemistry is inorganic chemistry, which deals with non-carbon compounds. The compounds other than the elements other than carbon are studied under inorganic chemistry, where their structure, function, synthesis, and identity is studied. And inorganic chemists, they do research related to metals, metallurgy. Then next we have is biochemistry, which is study of living chemistry in living things, and we call it a cross between biology and chemistry. So pharmaceuticals and genetics and effect the pharmacology, all these things are what biochemists study. Then next we have is physical chemistry. Physical chemistry, as the name suggests, it deals with the physics of chemistry, that is the forces of matter. And much of physical chemistry is computational. Physical chemists, they develop theoretical ideas, they do modeling for new compounds. And then the last broad classification is analytical chemistry, which is the chemistry of high precision measurement, you find composition. This is qualitative as well as quantitative analysis. And analytical chemists generally find work at forensics, quality control, and medical test organizations. Then these were the five broad classifications, but then chemistry is actually central science because it brings together mathematics, physics, EVS, and whatnot. It is the knowledge of nature of chemical processes and chemicals within the realm of biological and physical phenomena. And as you can see from this picture, that actually the fingerprints of chemistry are all over biochemistry, pharmacology, physics, geology, psychology, meteorology, electronics, and other scientific disciplines and areas of research. So chemistry is everywhere, chemistry matters, and so is study is important, and it opens wide options for you. Before we move on to the job profiles and everything, I would want to discuss some of the very important discoveries in chemistry. A discovery of radioactivity, which was by Madame Marie Curie. She was the physicist and chemist. Again, it's like, because chemistry is central science, so chemist as well as a physicist who worked on radioactivity. She was the first woman to win Nobel Prize, and in fact, the one who won two Nobel Prize. So she gave us the theory of radioactivity and discovered polonium and radium, very two important radioactive isotopes. Then we had Irvin Langmuir, who was again a Nobel Prize winner in chemistry. He gave studies related to surface chemistry and Langmuir isotherm, Frenzelit isotherm, which we all study. So he was the one who gave a breakthrough in surface chemistry. Then Linus Pauling, he was awarded Nobel Prize in 1954. He was founder of fields of quantum chemistry and molecular biology. Besides this, he gave an accurate scale of electronegativities of elements, which is still in use. So his work is commendable. Then John Dalton, Professor Dr. Thakur just mentioned the three laws which John Dalton gave, and he is known as father of atomic theory. So, I mean, he was the one who gave the correct definition of atom. And then George William Gray, who is the founder of LCD screens, because of which we have such sleek televisions, we have sleek phones because of this LCD. And polyethylene, one of the most used chemical, I would say, and also which is posing a threat to the environment also. So 80 million tons of polyethylene is produced every year, and currently it's a major concern of environmental pollution. So this is also a discovery of chemistry which we cannot imagine our life without, because it has become so important in our life. So these discoveries are something that actually encourage us, challenge us to make something new, because these things have been discovered quite in past, and now is the time we find new things, we discover new chemicals, we discover new things that can be of use. Now let's discuss what can you do with the degree in chemistry. But then I would say this is not a very correct question, because the question should be what you cannot do with chemistry. Because you can actually do anything with a chemistry degree. A degree in chemistry will teach you to think about and analyze the world around you. And importantly, a chemistry degree opens the door to a variety of career options. Just excuse me. Shashank sir, everything is going fine? My voice is clear?
Yes, ma'am, your voice is clear.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. Yeah. Okay, just stretch the.
Yeah. Sure. Slide. Sure. Yeah. Fine now. Yeah.
Yeah.
So let's just discuss what are the programs or courses that you can take up. After 12th standard, BSc Honors Chemistry degree is for you, which is actually a three-year program, three-year degree program, which helps in building an advanced professional or academic career. A candidate should have passed 10 plus 2 or equivalent exam so as to be eligible for this BSc honors degree and should have studied chemistry as a compulsory subject. Now then, what after BSc chemistry? The most commonly and most recommended option is master's in chemistry, which is a career-oriented postgraduate course of 2 years. And the course is specially curated for the students willing to gain a more powerful grip over the areas of chemistry. And it is an appropriate course for those who wish to pursue PhD and a research or academic career. For a master's degree, the eligibility is that you must have a minimum of 50 degree score in your undergrad study where you have studied chemistry as a compulsory subject. And there is a, this is a list of some of the popular MSc chemistry exams like DUET for Delhi University, JNUE, which is an exam for Jawaharlal Nehru University, IPU, Guru Gobind Singh Indraprastha University conducts this exam, IPU CAT, BITSTAT, BHU, BHU is an exam for Banaras Hindu University. So these are the entrance exams which help you get into master's program. Then master's program, post-master's program, what you can look for. Over the past years, actually, MSc chemistry has emerged as one of the most sought-after courses in India. After MSc chemistry, you can go for MPhil chemistry, which is a one-year full-time postgraduate philosophy course in chemistry, or one can opt for PhD in chemistry, which is a three-year doctorate course in chemistry. A doctorate degree in chemistry will enable one to keep expanding knowledge and provide research training as well. Candidates having completed their master's degree and MPhil can apply for PhD. Another option can be after master's degree is that you can opt for PG diploma courses, which make you job ready. In fact, our university, GD Goenka University, also offers PG diploma courses, which are 1 year course. Like we have PG diploma courses for cosmetics and environment, health and safety. Similarly, you can find some other PG diploma courses which can be opted after master's degree in chemistry, which can help you get a job easily. Then after master's, we have doctor of philosophy, PhD, as is discussed. During this PhD, if you are NET in GATE qualified, then you can get a scholarship. And candidates who have cleared the exams like CSIR, NET, JRF, GATE, and LISA usually offered fellowships while pursuing PhD courses. And apart from this, universities such as IGNU and Delhi University also offer fellowships to the students pursuing full-time PhD courses with them. So pursuing a higher degree will not only serve as a gateway to advanced work opportunities, but will also offer immense knowledge of this subject. Now, after PhD, if you are really research oriented and you are keen to discover something new and you are really interested, then there is an option that you go for postdoctoral research. Postdoctoral research can be for 1 year, 18 months, and depending on what is where you choose it to go for. So after PhD, postdoctoral research is another option. So this is about the basic courses that you can study in chemistry. Then let's talk about what can be the job profiles and what kind of roles that you get after studying chemistry. Chemical scientists or chemists are like magicians, as they know how to convert matter into really amazing things and actually sometimes into odd smelling things as well. So chemists, they can create new molecules, new materials, uncover new phenomena and create new problems that raise new questions. And chemists are actually experimentalists. If the results contradict a theory, then the theory must be wrong. So chemists unearth problems of sufficient complexity and interest a new field of science is created to address it. Now, what kind of job chemists do, chemical scientists do, the jobs depend on area of specialization. However, they are mainly two kind of jobs, which, I mean, this is divided into two classes, the production jobs and non-production jobs. Production work requires handling raw material and managing the production process, as well as operating high technical equipments. Whereas non-production job, it's like technical and managerial staff, marketing and administrative work, where you do not have to really handle the raw material. In non-production jobs, people work with research and development chemists and engineers for helping them develop new products and to create marketing plans and inform the customers of company products and services. So there is a line between production jobs and non-production jobs. It's up to you what kind of job you opt for. And as we discuss the types of the broad classification of chemistry, on that basis we have organic chemist, inorganic chemist, physical chemist, analytical chemist, industrial chemist, like all these from organic to analytical chemist, I would say, as we discuss, that they work on, like, organic will work with carbon compounds, inorganic chemist will work with non-carbon compounds, physical chemist will work with computational work. So similarly, we have like chemical engineers who design chemical manufacturing processes and equipments. Agricultural chemists, they research for better and improve crop cultivation, developing fertilizers and agricultural chemicals. Then what is actually a chemist expected to do? What are the works a chemist do? Industrial growth has created a great demand for trained chemists, and this trend is expected to continue. A chemist is expected to study chemical analysis, synthesis, research, and sampling of solids, liquids, or gases for determining their composition, properties, physical, and chemical changes. Using the findings for developing new products through improved production process and advanced scientific research, a chemist is expected to test samples, make quantitative and qualitative analysis, and also work on research projects for improving methods of production and for devising new products. Some of the job profiles, and needless to mention, the job profiles I'm going to discuss are some of the job profiles which you might not find in India, but they are very much popular in abroad. So I have taken up those profiles which are common and can be taken up in India as well as in abroad. Besides like scientist or a chemist in a pharmaceutical company, the other job profiles can be a science communicator. A science communicator uses scientific knowledge to explain complex science to the public so they can understand and appreciate the value of these discoveries that are important to their everyday lives. One can be a patent attorney, where you help the inventors get legal protection, like filing of patents for their new inventions and new medicines. Then you can be an associate principal scientist in food industry, where the role can be to predict how different food chemicals will enhance the taste and texture of food, and also can work upon food flavoring as well as food preservatives. So that is what chemical scientists are required in food industry. Then bioanalytical chemists, testing of new medicines in various stages of drug development to ensure they are robust and reliable before being released onto the consumer market, is what a bioanalytical scientist do. Then in the industry of printing and inks, development chemists make custom inks like which can be for food like eggs, or it can be for packaging material. So they test the vitality, the usage, their effect on the body and everything. That is what a development chemist in printing and inks industry do. Then another profile can be a research innovation manager, which is involved in some cutting edge research like developing ways to make plastic biodegrade quickly. Next we have is Flavorist and Innovation Director, which again checks for or creates for new flavors. A forensic toxicologist to ensure public safety through toxicological testing of everyday items like food, cosmetics, electronics. Another profile can be Sustainability Manager, which as the name suggests that you work for advice, vital role have in advising businesses and chemists about how to be more green and sustainable. An Atmospheric Chemist is involved in finding ways to minimize the impact of humans on natural world. Then a Nanotoxicologist who examines on nanomaterials and how they affect medicine, electronics, and clothing interacting with the body. Then a toxicologist, other than in forensic, in chemical companies also toxicologist is required, who ensures the company's chemicals are safe and comply with strict rules and regulations. Then consumer products technician, and also the household goods technicians or senior scientists who check and develop materials related to consumer products like cosmetics, chewing gum, and other household products like toothpaste, shampoo. So these are the fields, these are the sectors, these are the profiles where the chemist can go on to, and the list is like quite long. Then we have Medical Research Council Board member. Like we have funding agencies, so you can find a place there as a board member or a secretary who decide, who assess and discuss the funding proposals. Then an astrochemist who in collaboration with physicists, they investigate the regions of space between the stars. An environmental chemist helps to protect the environment by assessing the risk to life from certain chemicals in the soil, water, or air. A fragrance evaluator, and the list is actually quite long. Let me give me a list of recruiting sectors where you can find jobs. These were the profiles. So recruiting sectors can be government and private research laboratories, academic institutions, pharmaceutical firms, army service corps as food scientists, paint manufacturing firms, rubber industries, fertilizer companies, food industries, packaging industries, forensic labs, consultancy firms, pesticides company, cosmetic industries, agriculture firm, and the list is not over yet. Sanitary and sewage treatment plants, water treatment plants, paper and pulp industry, metal and extraction industry, food and beverage industry, cement industries, healthcare industries, textile manufacturers, environment and analytical services, and so on. List is still not complete, and that is why I said what you cannot do with chemistry. Besides this, civil services are an option for those who prefer not to be in a scientific profession but in administration. Then I have listed a few professions or like further study after like undergrad or post graduation in chemistry. Then one can opt to study medicine, law, or dentistry, or can go for a business school. How is that possible? Because when you study BSc degree in chemistry, then it is an ideal pre-medicine degree because it provides a broad scientific background and a solid foundation for medical school. So after BSc degree, you can also go to a medical school or you can go to a law school where intellectual property law is a unique field and a field of law relating to inventions, designs, and discoveries. And after BSc degree, you can also opt for dentistry. And if you are interested in management courses, administrative courses, you want to be an entrepreneur, an inventor, then you can definitely opt for MBA after BSc degree. Besides this, I already mentioned about packaging and processing food industry. They also offer viable options. In healthcare too, chemistry graduates are opting for medical laboratory technology as well as in sales of pharmaceuticals. And this is not so known, but chemistry researchers also find work in museums, in art conservation and restoration, carbon-14 dating, and also in analyzing the genesis of artifacts through chemical procedures of analysis, which only chemists can do. Now, how is chemistry at GD Goenka University? Although chemistry can be divided into a number of branches, organic, analytical, physical, inorganic, but at our university, you are not required to specialize. Our programs not only teaches you the core chemistry, but it also emphasizes on communication skills through writing and presentation. Additional optional courses in languages, computer science, and other fields can strengthen your knowledge and give you an edge in the job market. Both UG and PG courses, they are designed to give students adequate theoretical knowledge and practical skills needed for a leading chemist. We do take two industrial visits, and we also invite industrialists to our organization, to our university, to deliver some lectures so that students can interact. Also, the projects, students have to mandatorily go for summer projects. Their one semester in master's program is for industrial project only. So that gives a great exposure to the students. And they make them ready for, they make them industry ready actually. The courses here are such. And with the phenomenal growth in frontier areas of food, health, pharma, cosmetics, paint, electronics, material industry, several courses are part of our curriculum. We give choices, we have departmental electives. So depending on your interest also, you can choose the courses. And opportunities exist for higher studies both in India and abroad, and one could diversify, specialize into advanced areas leading to careers in aerospace, nanomaterials and technology, drug design and development. Now, this is what chemistry is at GD Goenka University, but what else our university has got to offer you? GD Goenka University is a world-class education. We have faculty from leading institutions. We have national and international conferences regularly organized at our university, workshop, guest lectures, exhibitions and seminars, which expose our students to a thought-provoking environment. International student mobility through summer internship, semester abroad programs, and articulation with more than 40 higher education partners around the world, that is our USP of our university. University has been good ranks, gold ranking in by IGOS, Times B School, Times of India. They have all given us good ranks, ranked number one in India and so on. Then our university also offers student scholarships. Scholarships of up to 100% can be offered to the most deserving candidates. Study abroad, we have connections, we have collaborations, MOUs signed with several universities abroad. We have student exchange programs where our students can go and study for one semester. We have MOUs signed with universities at the USA, Australia, Netherlands, France, UK, China, Turkey, Canada, Malaysia. So all these places we have MOUs signed, or we have connections where students can go for their studies. This is a list of schools at GD Goenka University. Then specifically School of Basic and Applied Sciences, we have a vision to be a premier research intensive school through innovative education, leading edge interdisciplinary research, entrepreneurship and internationalization. And all this we achieve, we try to achieve through a lot of work, which I am going to describe in the coming slides. Professor Ramkrishna Thakur, Dean of School of Basic and Applied Sciences, who has always been a pioneer in achieving and helpful us, and has been helpful in achieving the mission and vision of the school. He is a dual doctorate degree and has a lot of experience in teaching and research. The faculty members we have from reputed institutes like IITs, NITs, IIT Bangalore, and some have even postdoctoral experience from Germany, Europe, and USA. From Department of Physics, we have faculty who are involved in research like ultra cold molecules, type I supernova, computational biophysics. Department of Chemistry, we have faculty who are from IITs, from BITS, mostly we are from IITs and University of Rajasthan. Then these are the research interests. These are the research fields in chemistry: medicinal chemistry, coordination chemistry, transition metal complexes, wastewater treatment, photosensitizers. Then we have faculty from mathematics who are involved in research, whose research interests are linear algebra, numerical methods, robotics, MATLAB, probability and stats. Department of Biological Sciences, they work on drug delivery, diabetes, heavy metal decorporation, drug resistance, aquatic ecology, microbial biofilms. And then Department of Forensic Sciences, the faculty is working on forensic medicine, question document, forensic ballistics, wildlife forensics, anthropology, forensic toxicology. These are the research interests of our faculty. Then currently we have more than 30 PhD scholars registered in various departments of our school. We also have funded projects. More than 50 lakhs have been procured from Government of India. Then the labs, state-of-the-art lab facilities at School of Basic and Applied Sciences. This is the list of undergraduate programs in School of Basic and Applied Sciences. These BSc pass courses, these have been recently introduced. These are new. So maybe if you have somebody who is interested in these, then they should be informed that our university is offering these past courses. Then we also have MSc in Wildlife, MSc Geology, MSc Forestry, MSc Biophysics, which are only very countable universities, I would say, which are offering. So GD Goenka University is a pioneer in offering such courses as well. Then we have PG Diploma. As I mentioned, that after MSc, one can go for a 1 year PG Diploma course. Then best practices, student mentoring. Each student is assigned a mentor. Mentors are there to discuss their problems related to their studies, and also if they are facing some problems in even at personal level, some of the students have been open to their mentors, because we do provide a very warm relationship to the students. When a mentor talks to a student, it's not only a teacher-student relationship, it's actually a mentor relationship. So this is a very I would say a very best practice which is followed here, and mentors generally do their best to solve the problems. However, if it is not solved, then we have the HODs and dean, and the problems get solved very soon. We have SIM login, the ERP system where students can check their attendance, their marks, and all the details. Experiential learning, as I mentioned, that we have conferences, faculty development programs, student development programs, workshops, symposium, distinguished lectures and practice schools. Distinguished lecture by Dr. Kumar Krishnan, who is a senior scientist at NASA, was organized in August 2019. However, he has also now he'll soon be delivering a webinar for us on 11th of August. He has recently agreed to it. So I would say, I mean, that was a very, very good talk which he delivered. So if you are interested, then I would say that you must join his talk on 11th of August 2020. Then these are the pictures when he came here to the university. Professor P.B. Sharma also delivered a talk. Professor P.B. Sharma, he is founder, vice chancellor of DTU. So these, Professor D.K. Oswald, director, NPL Laboratory, he gave a talk on why India needs to strengthen its quality infrastructure. All these talks, all these sessions, these guest lectures, these are very, very important, and they actually add a lot of good learnings to the students, and we keep on conducting these lectures and also the visits time to time, because these really help in development of students. Then we also celebrate great scientists' birthday, like we celebrated Charles Darwin's birthday. Workshops, national workshop on strengthening criminal justice was conducted. Then several visits, like visit to NPL, visit to IUAC, visit to IIT labs, visit to Delhi University, visit to AIIMS, these visit to chemical industry, and then national conferences online as well as offline that are also conducted, that are also organized by our university, an international conference in collaboration with Arizona State University was conducted in February 2020. Then World Environment Summit was also organized. And some of the best practices, which is again outreach program, like we conduct plantation drives within collaboration with an NGO, Eco Rakshak. We had organized this plantation drive. School awareness programs are conducted. Then we have outreach programs where our faculty visits different schools and give some talks or sessions on awareness about science education. We, under the School Connect program, we also invite students from different schools or colleges, and we explain them some laboratory practices and some general science related activities. These are some of the images where we have invited students from Government Senior Secondary School, Badshahpur. We had invited students from Dronacharya College. And this was DST Inspire Science Camp, which were organized in January, which was funded by Department of Science and Technology, DST, Government of India, where we had invited students from almost all over the India, and we had some 150 students from different schools who stayed with us in the campus for 5 days. Then training and placement, we have a TPC cell, training and placement cell, which is crucial link between academic programs and suitable employment options for the students. These are some of the training and placement, some of the companies where our students get placed, and some of the students after their BSc chemistry degree and MSc chemistry got placed last year. These are the students, they got positions at project manager or subject matter expert. And this is the website. You can access this, you can go through the links. And that's all from my side. Thank you. And this is like open for the questions.
Well, thank you, Dr. Sonika Sethi, for such an enlightened talk. You have really expanded huge possibility for in the field of chemical sciences, and also what we are doing at GD Goenka University at the School of Basic and Applied Sciences. I'm sure it will be really very much helpful for all our students, attendees, whomsoever have joined this one. And now we open a session for the questions. So, Dr. Kamle.
Yes, sir.
Please.
So there are no questions in the chat box as such, mm-hmm. as of now. But if any of the students has any question, they can unmute their mic one by one, and we can take your questions one by one. So if any student has any question, you can ask one by one, or you can even write in the chat box.
Yeah, I think it is better to write on a chat box, and then we will ask a question. So it is equally important for attendees to ask some good question related to the talk. No question? I think someone has written in a chat box.
Yeah, so there is one question. What are the other chances rather than research in biochemistry? Sonika, ma'am?
Other than research in biochemistry, Mohammed Sanju, ma'am, other than biochemistry, you have chances of research in pharmaceuticals, chemical industry, pharmaceutical companies, research in there. That was a long list of industries where you can go for research. It can be food industry, it can be paint and inks industry, it can be polymer industry. All these industries are open for research. We still have a lot of options available where we still have research probabilities open.
Yeah, so since this is a biochemistry, I think we have also Priyanka Tyagi. So, Dr. Tyagi, would you like to add something? Dr. Tyagi is here.
Yes, sir. Good afternoon.
Very good afternoon. Yeah. Would you like to add something on top of Dr. Sethi?
Yeah, I guess Dr. Sethi has very well explained that apart from biochemistry, the students can go for the pharmaceutical industries.
Right.
And for chemistry, there are several industries which are related to the food, even the food industries and the beverage industries also they can go.
Right. So I think there is a huge possibility in the industrial sector. So a lot of industries are there, and they need actually the well-qualified, skilled, trained, young, talented people who have a really clear vision, and there is a lot of possibilities. Thank you, Dr. Sethi and Dr. Tyagi, madam, for exploring the possibilities. Any more questions?
So there are no more questions in the chat box.
Well, so I just would like to, since this is just an interaction, mutual interaction to understand the science, different aspect of science. So here I've gathered one information, not now, but I think for last few years before, I'm quite interested in, as it came into my mind after seeing this question of a student. So usually, you know, in our country, the survey says that more than 45% students at high school drop out at urban or village area. Then the question is what they do. They work at an unorganized company sector as an unskilled labor. And since the student is a dropout at a high school, so they work as an unskilled labor and produce low quality products. So the producing low quality product will lead to the low wages and also the exploitation. You might be heard or seen in a television that a lot of questions are going on about the low quality product, low wages, exploitation, why it happens. Just because somehow the student people do not get sufficient motivation to pursue the higher education, go up to the above the higher school. So at least, so we have to stop this by encouraging young and ignited mind to pursue a higher studies. You know, that is the reason behind framing all this series and giving you a step by step information about the different stream of science. You know, it is the, and also at the same time, international ILO, international labor law, they say, they have broadcasted data, and this says that more than 80% people in Germany, Japan, and South Korea are highly skilled workforce, and therefore they are manufacturing top quality products and providing to rest of the world. You know, even in our country, we find the Korean goods, most of the Korean electronics or a Japanese electronics or a German electronics, and it is a really very much reliable, at the same time expensive as well. Why? Because we import, and it is produced by our skilled labor. So this is the time not to think, but to act. So encourage our young and ignited mind to pursue higher education. At least they should go for a diploma-like course, at least undergraduate or a diploma, PG diploma-like course, a skill-based course that will provide opportunity to work in an industrial sector as well as a skilled labor, and therefore producing a top good quality of product and no matter of low wage or exploitation, you know. So all that we have to stop it. And we can do only by motivating young and talented people to remain in a science domain and go further, study further, take further a step, you know. So that's what my message is for this session. And besides that, as I can see, the next session is, eighth session is a plan on physics and astronomy, the career prospect. This is the eighth session of our science education career prospect. In total, we have framed for 10 sessions. So still after this, today's session, we have three sessions. One is on a physics, other is on a geology and environmental science. And one more session we do have, I suppose. So anyway, thank you once again. I thank all the audience, wonderful audience, attendees, faculties, faculty members, and proud parents for attending very peacefully the talk, listening very carefully. And at the same time, I would like to extend thanks to Dr. Sonika Sethi for presenting the complete talk very sincerely, systematically, and in an organized way. Thank you, students, for your interactive discussion as well. And we do hope that in the next session, we will have a more interactive discussion. We encourage such kind of the discussion that will rectify your doubts running inside the mind. And you have to be, I'm talking to the student, you have to be shy off from all this kind of the things. You have to ask, open your mind, ask your question, whatever the doubt you have. You know, everyone has some kind of a doubt. So we are here to rectify your doubt, to navigate you, to give you the right suggestion. We have a pool of experts, more than 25 faculty members joining this session. So that you might have experience time to time when I ask a question. or you ask a question and our faculty members besides resource person explain to you. So again, thank you audience, thank you attendees for your patience and carefully listening this talk. I again request you to inform all your near dear colleagues, friends, to attend rest of our session. The next forthcoming is on physics and astronomy, the career prospect. The session speaker is our Dr. Sasikant Gupta. Dr. Gupta is heading the physics department. He is a PhD from IISc, Indian Institute of Science, and a very learned personality. He has expertise in astrophysics, and certainly I will be with all of you. So again, thank you, audience. Thank you, Dr. Sethi, and thank you, Dr. Kamle, and your Augustus team, who have provided continuous support to organize all the sessions one after another very carefully, smoothly, for the benefit of our students. Thank you so much again. I wish you a nice and wonderful afternoon. Take very good care of yourself. We will see you in the next session. Thank you. Take care.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, sir.